visited the testing lab down in Pennsylvania to see the testing of the curtain wall mock-up. This is a full-scale mock-up. In some areas, it's over 30 feet high. That basically represents all the different textures and fixtures and components of a curtain wall system. A lot of people don't know what a curtain wall system is, and it's basically the exterior of the building, mostly glass in this facility that we're building in the Sherman Center. It's very important for the owner and the customer to actually see the testing of the curtain wall system. We've got some past history here on the campus with the original construction of the medical school and the hospital back in the 70s. We had some problems with the granite. We had some problems with the windows, and we actually replaced the entire façade, the entire curtain wall on the campus. So we know that the pains and agony of a façade that doesn't work. So all the other buildings completed since have all been, you know, more of a curtain wall. That's kind of the architecture that you have. And we've tested all of them. We've tested the LRB, we've tested the ACC, we tested the lakeside to ensure that, you know, we had a good solid facade. It was important to go down and see the different testing that we had. And that testing ranged anywhere between, you know, putting a large propeller in front of the window to generate over 70 mile per hour winds against the face of the building. At the same time of squirting it with water to see if we can push any of the water through the mullions, through any of the components of the system to see if we had any leakage. We do some pressure testing there. We do some static testing. We do some dynamic testing. We do some heating and cooling testing where they're actually put some nitrogen and cool the outside of the building down, the outside of this mock-up, all the way down, I believe it's minus 10 degrees Fahrenheit to see if you still get the thermal insulation throughout the building. And then we'll actually heat that same area up over to, I think it's up to 150 degrees Fahrenheit to make sure that you keep the interior of the building as a typical 70, 72 degrees Fahrenheit inside. All the testing down in Pennsylvania met, if not exceeded, all the design specifications of this product.